Let me tell you this story, folks. It's about a guy named Jan, and it begins when he was 16, growing up in a rural village outside of Kiev, Ukraine. And as he told Forbes recently, this was not the greatest place or time to be Jewish. So 16-year-old Jan and his housekeeper mom decide to move to America. Dad, he can't afford to come. And to save just a few pennies more, they fill a suitcase with Soviet-issue pens and notebooks so this boy would have supplies at his new school in glorious California. They land in Silicon Valley, where mom gets a job and then gets cancer. And they survive on her disability insurance and food stamps. Jan gets in a bit of trouble at school, but at the same time, teaches himself computers with manuals from the used bookstore. He enrolls at San Jose State, but then drops out when Yahoo calls with a good job. And there he befriends a guy named Brian, who takes him under his wing when Jan's mom passes away. After almost a decade of mostly soulless engineering work at Yahoo, they quit, blow some of their savings on some travel, and go to South America, play some ultimate frisbee. They apply for jobs at Facebook and get rejected. But using one of those Soviet notebooks he was saving for special projects, Jan draws up plans for something called WhatsApp. His invention would allow a person to message anyone on any device anywhere in the world for free. And in just a couple years after launch, it explodes. And then Mark Zuckerberg calls. And at the Facebook founder's house, over chocolate-covered strawberries on this Valentine's Day, they strike a deal. And this week, along with their main investor, the guys make a symbolic trip back to the social services office where Jan used to line up for food stamps, and they sign the papers that make these guys billionaires. Now, to put this in perspective, Aaron, factoring in tonight's market cap, Walmart is worth about $108,000 per employee, GM, a little over $273,000, Apple, almost a whopping $6 million per full-time employee. But WhatsApp just sold for $344 million per employee. They only have 55 people working there, although they are hiring.